Hey guys, welcome to the Cummings residence at our kitchen here. It's long overdue. I know it's crazy trying to put all this together into a video, but I know that.
What are we doing?
Gosh, I really don't know. I just kind of like always.
It looks like a cooking video.
Yeah, cooking video. I thought you were asking me what we're making here, but
no.
Every evening that I undergo these creation, because you are definitely helping.
I'm a part of it. Yeah, of course. I'm the cutter.
Yeah. She's my assistant.
Okay, where's my knife?
Oh, you need your knife. Go get your knife. That would help. Every night is just an amazing production of what I like to call our healthy bowls. We start off with empty bowls, and in our empty bowls, it depends. Some nights I will make rice with either lentils, black beans, and just put all sorts of different flavors. And oh, we gotta put this guy in here, which we'll show you what's in there in a little bit. But it's a masterpiece, it's creation. It's my form of therapy. I become one with the food that I create, the food that's going to nourish our bodies. Because it's very important for people to realize that you're not some garbage disposal, you know, where you just put things in. Your body is your temple, and you should love and take care of your temple with foods that have nutrition and value and love to nourish and keep you healthy. And as you become healthy, your weight will fall off as you.
I'm finding that out because in the past I used to, like, people that watched my YouTube videos in the past, they've seen, like, I used to rollerblade like 40 miles or so, or run 10 miles, and then I would figure, hey, I exercise so I can eat whatever I want. But
that's a mistake.
That was a huge mistake because I couldn't get rid of the gut.
And never mind that. It's just like, if when you're working out and you're expelling a lot of energy, which is what calories is, and your body is void of nutrients like minerals and vitamins and all sorts of different things that your body requires, you know, your protein, your carbs, and your healthy fats, all the micronutrients, to keep you healthy, to keep you vibrant and alive, as well as hydration with water and sleep. These are all things that people do not put into consideration, and decreasing your stress level. So these little beauties here, which, you know, things that grow like your tomatoes, you know, tomatoes and your basil and your scallions and your sun-dried tomato and, you know, tofu, which
tofu
is made out of tofu tonight. Yeah.
What's tofu made
of? Tofu is made out of soy, and it's a really good source of protein for the individuals that are vegan and require, you know, some form of essential fatty essential amino acids and things of that nature. I do highly recommend, and I'm gonna like go in here real quick, for those individuals that are, you know, vegan, you have to supplement, because a lot of the fruits and vegetables that you're eating are demineralized because they're void of minerals unless you compost and you create your own mineralization in your soil. But organic spirulina is an extremely potent nutrient that has all the essential amino acids, fatty acids like omega-3s, and things of that nature that your body's required to actually get good source of the things that you need. Biotin is another good one. We do vitamin C as well, and then of course vitamin B12. So
if you're a vegan,
that's like a must to keep yourselves, because you're not going to be able to eat the amount of foods that your body requires to have all those nutrients in there. You would have to eat loads and loads and loads of these bowls. And that's why a lot of vegans and vegetarians fail, because they don't eat enough. You always heard of counting calories for less amount, because you want to keep it, as the fitness industry tries to tell you, 1,200
calorie
a day.
Counting.
Yeah, that's bad. You're chasing your tail.
Biggest loser stuff, how about that?
Yeah, that's terrible stuff. You know, we never want to listen to that. But anyway, so it's important to get, this is Yuca. I'm not quite sure many of you have heard what Yuca is, or Yucca, whatever you want to call it. We buy it, and it's frozen. Obviously, you're better off getting fresh, but frozen fresh is just
is
as good.
Is it called something else, though, in English? Cassava?
Cassava, yeah. Cassava. And, you know, I love, it's either rice, and I want to point out, we are raw till 4. We only eat fruits and greens raw, not altered in any way, till 4 o'clock. And in the evening time, we keep it vegan.
It's a fiesta.
And we only really have two big meals a day, and sometimes we'll have a little snack of, you know, sun-dried tomatoes with...
those are so good. I mean, they're like a great, just a snack. It's like the texture of, like, you know, if you like beef jerky and stuff like that, it doesn't taste like beef jerky, but it kind of takes the place of it.
Oh my God, it's just delicious all the way. And so, you know, when the two meals that we do have are very potent, so we try to get the most of our calories in these two meals. So anyway, tofu with yuca, and everything that we do over a bed of lettuce. So I just kind of like go in here, you know, and divvy up like two big handfuls there. I try to like.
Yeah, and we're ready to go. That's it, we're done.
No. Not at all. I just try to make sure that we're
even.
Out.
You like being even, Steven.
Yeah.
Well, we used to live in a villa in New Mexico. You would take like certain items and stuff and weigh them on a scale.
Yeah, and we do have a scale.
To see how much things weigh.
Yeah, we do have a scale. But you know, a lot of times you kind of learn. I mean, I know what I grab.
Just about.
And fluff it up. And these are spring mix, you know, where we just, you know, your refrigerator is just veggies and fruits and grains and greens. Actually, not so much grains. We don't really do much grains. We do quinoa every so often with the rice. I like to mix
quinoa.
Quinoa, yes.
Yeah.
And I mix that all in. But okay, let's get cooking here. Let's take a look over here. For those of you who cannot afford organic, and I know organic is very expensive, you can buy the non-organic stuff. At least try to keep it local, because at least you're getting, you know, foods that is not radiated and sent from one state to another. So try to keep it at least local if you can't afford organic.
Right.
If you can't afford organic, and sometimes we get organic, sometimes we don't, you want to actually use apple cider vinegar and put it inside the water where you're retaining it.
Wait a minute, that's my job.
I know, but you're taking care
of
it.
Okay, all right. I'll let you have my job.
Okay, and you know what? I usually put a little bit of this into where I'm going to make my salad dressing. So before I put it away, put a little bit of apple cider vinegar in there.
That's the secret.
I'm the type of cook that I like to put away as I'm doing, because I hate major messes. And so that goes there. All right, so.
So then we take the apple cider. Put it in?
Yeah, ready to put it in.
Okay. So we take it, we just kind of spin it.
You see how the water has that color and that apple cider vinegar smells. And apple cider vinegar is actually very good for you in the sense that it creates healthy gut bacteria in your body and in your intestines and all that good stuff. And it also helps you lose weight, because there's something within that enzyme that helps you digest better.
Right.
And when you're digesting better, your body tends to not want to store, but utilize the food that you're eating. So there's a lot of fun things going to go on here on this particular video. But do you want me to take these out?
No, I'll get them.
You'll get them?
Yeah, because you got to start.
Okay, so, all right, so let's see here. I'm going to go ahead. I'm going to go ahead and cut up the garlic. I love to use garlic. Garlic is one of those things that I just adore. And it's an antibacterial, antifungal. Makes food taste really good.
Tomatoes this time.
Oh, I know.
These are like huge.
Yeah.
And awesome. Yeah. You don't mind if I
put it right there? No, not at all. Put it right there. And
zucchini. I just put this under a tap of water, you know, to get the apple cider vinegar off of it, because
I like to leave it on, like I said, because it actually helps with the digestion of food.
Hmm.
And so, I mean, I highly recommend every morning for people to actually go ahead and take 2 tablespoons of apple cider vinegar mixed with warm water and drink that first thing.
Oh, it tastes so good.
No, it doesn't, but it's good for you. As you get used to it, and I love the apple cider vinegar in the dressing. It gives it that little vinaigrette.
What's that?
That is a type of, it's called culantro, or, you know, it's a sort of like giving it season. It's got, mm-hmm. culantro's got all sorts of herbs, and it's chili, you know, not chili, but it's got cilantro, peppers, onions, you know, granulated garlic and things of that nature, which I don't really like to use because it's got some chemicals, but you wanted it because it reminds you of what your mother...
Well, yeah, my mom used to make... It's called recaíto in Spanish, right. In Puerto Rican.
I don't really like it.
It's
I
like
prefer,
a cooking base.
I prefer to make my own, but she, you know, we got it because she enjoys it. And I add it in to the dressing sometimes just to give it a little extra kick, and I'll probably add it also to the tofu here. Cutting up
adjusted in here.
Yeah, it is. We have a lot of stuff. At least we have this. When we were in the villa, we didn't have hardly any room to cook.
It was pretty bad.
And yeah, even though it was bigger, the villa was way bigger than this, but the kitchen was just way too small.
Yeah.
But anyway.
But you know, you take what you can get,
and you
don't throw a fit.
No.
I was trying to prop the.
Yeah. Okay.
Stop cutting. Because it's my job, I'm a cutter.
Yeah, she
has. Not a cutter.
No, she...
Not that kind of cutter. Oops.
Yeah,
so yeah, I end up cutting the vegetables and you end up cooking everything. Because
yeah.
Mark's got this amazing touch in the kitchen. He's just... your dad was a cook, right?
Yes, my dad is.
And your mom.
My
She's
mom, on the other
too,
hand,
right?
No, my mom can't
she
cook.
Cooked,
my mom can't
KFC.
Cook.
She cooked the latest Chinese or whatever, probably.
No.
Takeout.
She was a great takeout person. My grandmother, on the other hand, did cook pretty awesome. I don't know about you guys, but I love fresh basil. The smell of it, it's just like an amazing thing. So what I do is I put some stock and all inside where I'm going to make. This is Ninja, by the way. And Ninja comes with a blender, and it comes with a little food processor. And I just kind of like, you know.
This is Ninja.
Yeah.
It's.
I just got to put stuff in there, the scallions, because it just like pulverizes everything for you. And let's see. Spoon.
Where's your spoon?
Here's my spoon. Okay. I kind of like have a little ADHD when it comes. I do a little bit of this, a little bit of that. I don't really. Have any rhyme or reason. I just go with what?
Kind of just go with the flow.
With the flow.
Of what you're
This is really good stuff. It's island salsa. It's got chunky mango, pineapple, and red jalapeno peppers.
We highly recommend going to Trader Joe's because it's such a great place to find these unique types of salsas and, you know, good prices on fruits and vegetables and stuff for the most part.
Yeah. So let me try to take out this big old chunk of.
And they're all over the country, too, so kind of.
I have tofu here. Now, I'm going to start doing the yuca. So when I do the yuca, I'm going to go ahead. I usually just, you know, boil it in water in our little rice maker there. And I add a little bit of, this is like salt-free seasoning. This
kind
is.
Kind of hold it so people can.
Oh, okay.
Yes.
Whoops. There we go. Salt, free seasoning.
Okay.
And then we got this right here. It's an Italian herb, and it's got a grinder, which I like because you're getting your stuff pretty fresh. You know, when the restaurant, I come in with a pepper.
Yeah.
And I get to do that. And I'm going to put a little bit of this. This is pretty good, too. We just bought this at Trader Joe. It's got a combination of, it's a product of South Africa, actually. It's got all sorts of, like, pepper and, gosh, what else has happened here? It's got mustard seeds, garlic, paprika, and pretty nice stuff. I'm going to put it here, too, for the salad dressing.
Now, does that stuff have, like, sodium in it?
It's got sea salt. Some of the sea salts, you can see some, but not a lot.
Is it good for you? Or?
Sea salt is, but you see it doesn't really have a heck of a lot. It's got more of the other stuff.
And the other stuff is all good for you?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, this is all natural. Can't get any better than that. You know, like I said, I usually put all the stuff into the salad dressing that I'm making as well. Oops, I got stuff all over the place. That's a bad thing about these grinders.
I love this table. It's like our everything table.
Yes, it's our office, it's our
massage table.
And add some of the garlic in there.
I gotta see how that's coming along.
Yeah, I got stuff all over the place there. Okay, so now I'm gonna get some sun-dried tomatoes, a couple of those.
So I just kind of cut the carrots in half, so, you know, keep it all even, or for the most part. And I have like green onions here, and we love our celery, and our carrots, our peppers, and our cilantro.
So, a secret that I learned is that you take tofu and you freeze it, and it's gonna change the consistency, the cooking consistency, the color of it. This one kind of broke a bit.
So, tofu is like, what exactly?
It's made out of soy. It's like a curd made out of soy. And, you know, it's a very much used vegan, vegetarian type of substance. So that you could actually make the stuff taste however you want, because it will, you can make desserts with it and use it like almost like cheese.
Yeah.
You could also make just like little cubes. You can even make veggie burgers out of it if you wanted to. You know, and it's just amazing stuff. You can't get any better than that.
So it kind of takes our place of meat.
Yeah, it does.
Substitution. A big
block. Yeah, I'm not going to use the whole thing. Although we could probably eat the whole thing, because when you eat like this, the beauty of eating like this is that you can eat a lot of it. So for anybody who's bulimic, anorexic, or, you know, loves their food, eating like this fortifies you the ability to eat a lot.
I mean, if you think that, you know, eating healthy is cutting your portions, that is probably the wrong way to go about it, because what happens is when we start eating healthy stuff, we can eat a lot of it because it's all good for you. Your body, I'm learning all this from Mark, your body knows exactly what to say that a carrot is, for instance. You know, it can recognize it.
It knows what to do with it.
Yeah.
Instead of storing it like, you know, food that it doesn't recognize, it gets stored as the toxin, you know, inside that. Those toxin cells, what people call fat cells. But when it's something it recognizes, and you've trained your body to utilize the food that it's eating, you become a fat-burning machine.
So and even while you're sitting down,
yep,
you're burning fat.
You sure are. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and put this one away for the water. Although, you think we could have it all, or is that...
I don't know.
I'm going to go ahead, because we eat.
Yeah.
We eat.
Wow. So we're going to have all that. And that?
Mm-hmm.
Whoa. So yeah, okay. It's crazy just how much you can actually eat and lose weight. Because I started out just, you know, back in February, I was like 176 pounds or something. And I thought that was good. But, like, I weighed myself yesterday, and I'm like around 160 now. And it's not the kind of weight where you just lose weight just for weight's sake, but you lose fat.
I'm going to go ahead and put this in the Hitachi. You want to, you know, that's what that bad boy looks like. And this is our... It's not really Hitachi, it's an aroma. I'm so used to using the word Hitachi, which is a steamer, rice cooker. And, you know, it's awesome. This one actually, because of the pressure eye stuff, it cooks really good. So you just hit the little button, and when it's done, it goes over to this side. It usually takes 15, 20 minutes to make the yuca soft. Yuca is an amazing nutrient. It has It's heavy on carbs, but it's low glycemic carbs, and it really has, it fills you up, and it gives you a lot of nutrients, a lot of.
And it's what our, you know, Taino heritage,
yeah,
you know, our people from the Caribbean islands used to eat, you know. So we're going to a more natural diet that really is historically kind of what our natives ate, you know.
So I'm now putting the garlic. Got to drop the leaf somewhere. Our tofu.
That can't happen.
No. Not with.
Because you're going to go out of your mind.
Yes.
And find it.
Well.
Just don't do it on the video.
No, I won't.
It doesn't look good when your butt's, you know, in the shot.
Yeah. So I'm going to take some of this basil and just kind of like, you know, take little pieces.
Can't you like smell it from here?
Where's my second?
I used to not like celery, and after my fast, it's like my taste buds opened up. Now it's like, it tastes really good.
It's awesome.
And that's the thing, people think, oh, you're not eating meat, oh, you're not eating a lot of pasta and grains and stuff. How do you guys get full? You know, I mean, that stuff's so boring. And it's like, oh my gosh.
This doesn't taste.
Oh my gosh. No.
There's nothing boring. It's so satisfying. We have no cravings. You know, it's because you're feeding your body nutrients that your body requires, you know, to be able to be healthy. The cell needs nutrients. What people are feeding their cells is not nutrients. It's just non. Their food items, or food, what is it called? Not their food type or food like items is not anything
right.
Food about it.
Right.
So.
The body doesn't really recognize it. So it does something different with that food or with that item that you think is food that's going into your body. And what it's doing is not something that you really want your body to do. It's starting to store stuff, and then you're wondering why you have a gut,
or sickness.
Why you're not feeling good, or
why your immune system is down, why your metabolism is shut down, because you're not feeding your body anything that the body can use. You know,
actually,
if it comes
yeah.
in a box, it's not food.
You know? I mean, people think that, you know, being malnourished is a sign of, you know, that people are like thin, but being malnourished is really not, it's really not about being thin. It's about what?
When you're malnourished, you're going to get a gut. You're going to develop a lot of parasites. Your body's just going to expand, and there's a lot of inflammation from all the food that you're eating. So you're getting fat, full of toxin, and malnourished because you're feeding your body zero nutrition.
Because your body doesn't recognize what it's taking in, and it's storing it. Like, it's starving itself.
Food types, like products, are mostly preservatives and additives and things that your body can't recognize. Okay, so I've taken some of the sun-dried tomatoes, and I've actually put it, you know, on top of the tofu.
Looks like pizza.
I know, right? We got garlic.
Cutting it up.
Garlic and all that good stuff on there.
This by itself will look great. You know, just as a salad.
I know,
but
that's not
yeah.
even complete.
Not
I'm
yet.
Gonna take
some, close.
Some of this zucchini. The rest is going to be asparagus, which is another fun thing that we're gonna do here in a minute. Putting some zucchini. Now, it definitely looks like a pizza. And then take this.
Use all of this cilantro, but we're gonna use some of it for a salad and also for a dressing. But into the ninja. Ninja. That's a good name for that thing because
it does.
It does. It's like a ninja.
It's just like really quickly and fast. And you notice how it took the top, or I don't know if you saw, it took the top of the tomato. I use every part. And things that you normally wouldn't use, I put it here in the salad dressing. So why throw it away? It's still useful. It's going to be like pulverize it. So, you know.
It's amazing how many things, you know, that are natural that we end up throwing away. Like we just found out something about like the avocado seed. Even that can somehow be used, and it has lots of nutrients in it.
So I'm putting tomato, two big chunks of tomatoes, in the salad dressing I'm making. And then, where's my... I'm going to grab a orange.
You know, cilantro sometimes is such a pain. Because it gets so like stuck in your fingers and stuff.
I know, that's one of the things.
But it tastes so good.
I love to cook, but I hate to get my hands all dirty, so you'll see me doing the rag or constantly going and washing my hands if I get stuff all over me. Because I don't like it.
Yeah.
Anyway, oranges make a great base for your salad dressing. Add a little lemon or lime juice, an orange, a little apple cider vinegar. And then you could always add a little bit of water just to give it a little, depends how thick you want. If you want a really thick salad dressing, then you don't add much water, just with the orange.
Orange gives it like kind of like an Asian zest to it or something, right?
Yeah, it does. There you go, that in there. And what I do now,
it's that moment where you gotta get the cilantro off here. And oh, all these wonderful tomatoes. Grape tomatoes are so good.
I'm gonna use a little bit of curry on the tofu to give it.
Wow, we got a bunch of tomatoes today. What's going on?
Did I put too much in there?
I usually use 6.
Oh.
And you got like 12. It's a special.
It's a special
day.
Yeah.
So, kind of going all out.
Okay, if you don't want to do them all, we could put them here and grill.
It doesn't matter.
Yeah, give them some grilled ones. More the merrier there.
Just want to show. You don't want me to cut them?
No, we'll just put them whole like that. And nice and.
Look at that. It's starting to look pretty festive.
Yeah.
It's like a Christmas meal.
Yep. All right, so let's see here. I'm going to grab and I usually like to create a little sauce. It's got mangoes and all that good stuff.
I love that sauce.
You could use it. Lemon. Sauce and then just kind of like glaze it. I mean, there's nothing boring about this. You know?
Good flavors.
Very islandy, Caribbean-y.
We haven't done this one yet.
No.
This is just like a new one that you just probably just came up with.
Yeah, I do. And
you're just like, okay, I'm in the kitchen, what am I going to make today?
I never plan what we're going to eat. It's just like what the spirit wants and what it needs. It's eating. It's one of those things. I kept getting out of the frame shot there. But, what I'm going to do now is add...
I really out of the frame shot.
Yeah, I had to go grab coconut flakes, unsweetened. and just kind of like. This is to die for.
That looks good uncooked.
I know, right? And then I'll take some raisins.
Drizzle them on top.
Drizzle them on top, and there's nothing more delicious than grilled raisins in the food there. I mean, look at how colorful, how delicious that looks. All natural, all healthy. You eat this way, non-preservative, things that are natural and healthy for you. You don't have to be so obsessive on what you're putting in, how much calories you're taking. On the contrary, you want a lot because this food has a lot of volume, a lot of water, and it will fill you up. So you have to almost like teach yourself to eat a lot.
And we buy bulk vegetables. You know, there's this place here in Fort Lauderdale where we get our veggies and stuff, and they sell by the big package. And what we do is we get these veggies in a big package, and then we kind of break them up into smaller little Ziploc storage bags and stuff. And usually we store the cilantro in a smaller bag, but we kind of, you know, squeeze the air out of it and just try to, you know, make it so that there's no air to make it so that there's no what?
Yeah, so the moisture.
The moisture.
What kills your vegetables and salads is the moisture because it creates bacteria and fungus. So you want to keep it as dry as possible.
And that's one of the things that we noticed when we were living in Silver City. The produce section was always drenched with water, you know, and then every time we went to go get like some produce, it was always like soaked and it was always like wet, and that just spells disaster for us.
Yeah, it just makes your produce go bad real quick, and that's not good. Not good at all. Okay, so now I'm going to cut some of these sun-dried tomatoes and put it directly. I love sun-dried tomatoes. I
mean, you do.
And they're
so
good.
More than I do.
They have so much nutrients to them and minerals, and then they're great fiber. You'll go to the bathroom, you know, I'll tell you, eat prunes. These are a lot tastier than prunes, and they have such fiber effect. Plus, they're kissed by the sun. These are laid out outside, and the sun dries them up. You could also do this on a dehydrator if you wanted to sun-dry or dehydrate your tomatoes. But I highly recommend, you know, sun-drying them in the sun because they're so good. Actually, let's show them the size of what we buy.
Well,
this is
it
huge,
is pretty big.
Huge. It's all sun-dried tomatoes. $23 for the big pack, but, you know, it lasts a good 6 weeks or so. I go through them like crazy.
We'll end up, you know, using them. And they never go bad, it seems like. No, it's still fresh.
Because that's one way. You know how beef jerky never goes bad?
Right.
Same thing, because you're removing what? The moisture. Mm-hmm. Moisture is what makes things go bad. You know, because there's so much stuff that only lasts in the refrigerator without going bad. Okay, now, let's see here.
For the next step, of course, you know, this is a lot slower than popping a, like, microwave meal into your, you know, microwave and eating in like 5 minutes, but
you know
what you gain in the end is something much greater than just the speed of having, you know, had your meal really quickly. Food is like a spiritual experience anyway, so you know, it's really not just what we've made it out to be here in America.
Fast food is not good for you.
If it's in a box, it's probably usually
terrible for you.
Typically not.
Okay, so now I divide everything up. Me, one for you, me, one for you, one for me. Okay, that's like a cheap size one, but one for you, like that.
And it's filling up. Our bowl see where we started and now look at where
we're at. We still have like the yuca, which we,
yeah.
You know, that's going to take a little bit, and then that's going to take a little bit to cook. But what we'll end up doing is once it's done, we'll probably shut it. Before it's done, we'll shut off the video, and when it's done, we'll.
Yeah.
But
show the finished product.
Yes.
This is pretty amazing. This is.
Yep, that is. Now, for those of you that say, well, I can't live without pasta, you know, pasta's not good for you. But there's a cure for that. You buy this thing, they're different, they're spiralizers. We got this in Target.
For
yes.
Like $7.
Lovely Target for like, yeah, almost $8,
yeah.
Seven something or another. So this thing is amazing. You like put your zucchini in there.
And it makes spaghetti out of it.
And it makes this tremendous spiral spaghetti.
The only way that it doesn't work is when you have too small of a zucchini.
Or it's too wet. But it's working.
And it works with cucumber too.
Yeah.
Not as good.
I don't like it as much with
no.
Cucumber, but
no. I love
stuff.
Zucchini. Look at that. It just made noodles.
Yep. That's what it does. It makes noodles.
Look at that.
It's a great forearm workout too.
He hasn't let me touch that thing. It's like, I don't know, it's like his motorcycle.
Yeah, it is. But it's amazing. Look, I mean, it's just like spaghetti.
Yes.
And weenie. You have a thin, I usually like to use a thin or a thick side that you can use.
And it's a real simple concept. It's just a blade, you know, inside.
Yep, right
that,
there.
Yeah,
okay. Okay.
You can't just like do that. Okay, so you see the little teeth. So it sits in there and then it just grinds it up. And when you get to the end, it has another, like, device for, so that you don't cut yourself.
Right. And you see how the parts, it's almost like a tortellini or whatever, it comes out from, it poo-poos it out.
And it's all edible.
Yeah.
Every part, except for the back piece there. It has like a natural handle. Look at that.
Yeah, I know.
It's like a natural, like, you don't have to do anything to spin it. It's got notches in it. It's crazy.
I usually use the knob here, or you could use this, but sometimes it doesn't work that great.
Yeah.
Because of, but
when you get down to the nub of it, you don't want to cut yourself, because those blades,
oh my god, they're sharp.
Are ridiculously sharp.
Ridiculously sharp is true.
And then to clean it, we just like use, you know, like a brush or something afterwards.
Yeah, a little toothbrush.
To the sink.
It's another thing, when you're done with your toothbrush, and you should change your toothbrush every 3 months or so, you could use them to clean stuff.
Yeah.
Instead of just throwing them away. You know, recycling things and using things as much as you can saves the planet and saves your pocketbook. Okay. I think that's it.
It's all she wrote.
And here you got that.
Did you get stuck?
Yeah, no, it's the tortellini thing. It looks just like you could eat that, so.
Usually, you give me something to try. Today?
Here you go.
You're being really chintzy.
That is boiled.
Zucchini.
Mm-hmm. It's very watery, very good.
It's so good.
So let's see. Oh, I'm going to leave this out for when the yuca, when the yuca comes out.
And the yuca is
let me
still
see. Yeah, it's
cooking.
Still cooking. So now we're going to put this in here, in the oven. I mean, this is a masterpiece.
It is.
Look at that. All vegan, plant-based. 20 minutes. I like to use like 450, like really get it in there. So like the faster, the better. It's like a little grill. But you could do it less, anywhere from 350 to 450. And 15-20 minutes, this has got a timer, I have it on 20.
And I just starts cooking.
Yep, sure does.
And it doesn't take very long.
No, not except for 20 minutes.
So then, what do we do with the
with
salad the
dressing
wait?
Now? Yeah, I'm gonna wait. So towards the end, I'll add a little bit of water. I've already added, you know, all the. Let me add a little cake and make it a little cake. And I don't, you know, I never like 2 teaspoons. No, I just kind of go with my feel. It's like, okay, this is, and pretty much I hit it on the money all the time. But yeah, it's really not that difficult to do, you know, to really make stuff from scratch, get yourself either a food processor or a Ninja.
That thing costs, what, $35?
$35 and came with that and the blender. And it's like amazing. I mean, you can make all sorts of sauces with that. You can make all sorts of smoothie with the actual blender. Oh. Yes. And I was going to cut up the pineapple and use it, but I'll leave that for tomorrow.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because it's probably after.
Yeah. It's probably, it's still a little green, but I usually love to put pineapple also in the dressing with oranges and the tomatoes and all that. I mean, it's just.
And it's great in here too.
Oh
just
yeah,
as
I cut up some fruit sometimes in there and put it in the.
You've done like apples.
Apples,
right?
And oranges and you name it. Just you know,
like,
mix it in.
What'd you do with the apples the other day when you made it?
Oh, I made it with the yuca. I cut
it
up and put it in to boil with the starch, and it's like apple pie.
The lost garlic.
Lost piece of garlic there. It's going to drive me crazy. But, I mean, this right here alone on itself, the dressing is to die for. Imagine adding the yuca and all that in there. It's a full dinner. So it's like salad bowls that are full of life, nutrition, and they're, if I say so myself, super delicious.
They are.
You know?
And this is just one recipe
yeah.
that you come up with.
Yeah, and you guys, we do have an ebook, and actually, you could also, it's either an ebook, and they could also get the hard copy or the, you know, the hard copy. Or the,
yeah, they can get a soft cover. Or
if you
or
go to transitionradio.net on the home page, on the right side, the book is announced there, and you'll be helping us out a lot, you know, by doing that.
Definitely.
We're going to try to bring you more fitness and nutritional videos and just information, because I think that knowledge is golden and your body is your temple. And I truly believe that we create our own diseases and we could actually remove our own diseases. I know doctors are needed in emergency situations and you know there are people that feel they need to go to doctors because they haven't developed that inner trust within their inner knowing as we healed your ringworm naturally.
Yeah.
And we've done your healing of your neck naturally, you know, we didn't do surgery, we didn't even do
living proof.
Therapy. The therapy that you received was my therapy and my energy work and eating these kinds of foods. So, you know, even mental disorder, even, and I hate to use the word disorder, mental conflicts and emotional stagnation that we as humans face causes a lot of ailments in what we call bipolar, schizophrenia, depression, anxiety. It's all chemicals gone awry inside your body and your brain. And once you take all those chemicals out, and once you learn to balance your life, meditate, and be in the now, present, loving, be grateful, all those so-called labels that they put on us will disappear. It doesn't happen overnight. But those pills that you take that you think you get an instant, you know the side effects. A list a mile long. Ask your doctor about side effects are blah, 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 blah.
Yeah, it's all really about pain management with doctors.
Yeah.
They don't really want to come to a resolution to, you know, eliminate your pain.
Nope.
They want to just be able to get you to a place where you can manage it. And what is life like when all you have to do is like, okay, you got hurt, but now you just have to live with the pain. And if you don't take this pill, then you're not going to be able to live without suffering.
Right. You know, I had a rotator cuff tear that I gathered when I was working as an occupational therapist in New Mexico back in, 2009. And, you know, they gave me the first surgery. A partial tear became a full tear. The doctor created a course of a problem, damaged my thoracic nerve. I couldn't sleep, sit, and do a bunch of things for a whole year. I went to therapy. They didn't help me because the conventional therapy doesn't help. That's why I didn't want you to go to conventional therapy. I wanted to be your therapist. I got tired of all hoking and poking. They weren't able to heal me. I had to buy a hammock to sleep in because I couldn't even sleep. I healed myself with nutrition, my own type of therapy, my energy work, and to this day, the rotator cuff that was fully torn, I healed on my own without any limits on range of motion. And if you ask anyone who ever had a full rotator cuff tear and had to have surgery, the majority of them have limited range of motion and still have pain. I have zero pain, and I healed it on my own. So.
And no doubt from eating like this.
Oh, definitely.
That definitely helped me overcome what I was dealing with last year when I had a traumatic car accident that nearly ended my life. And, you know, this time last year, we were eating vegan, not nearly as pure as we are now as far as lowering the fat.
Yeah, that's the key.
You know, because we were still eating nuts.
Yeah, you want to keep your fat to 10%. And the kind of fat that you want to do is the avocado. You saw that we split a half avocado and coconut. And if you're going to use coconut oil, I highly recommend that you use the organic virgin coconut oil. Okay, because that is very important. That's extremely important. The other stuff, you don't want to deal with. I mean, there's some things that you could skip on, but there's certain things like coconut oil, the spirulina, you want it to be organic. If not, you're messing with chemicals that could harm you in the long run. And your health, I mean, pay now or pay later. I mean, that's what I've always...
Basically, I mean, you know, people like to invest in stocks and mutual funds and things for the future. Why not invest in the future by eating right? You know, so that when you're older, you can actually move, you can actually live a life without pain, without having to go to the doctor.
Yeah.
Because it seems like that's what most people do with their retirement.
Yeah, they're in doctor's appointments.
They're spending it in their doctor's appointment.
You are what you eat, and it's so definitely important. You know, people spend more time painting their cars and worrying about their cars than they do about themselves. They don't sleep right, they don't drink enough water, they don't eat enough vitamins and minerals that come in the source of food. The vitamins and minerals and pills, you know, the only reason we take those, like B12, you would have to eat so much, like spinach and things of that nature, or fish. And we do fish every so often.
Yeah.
You know, we're not... that's the only part that we're not fully 100% vegan, because we do fish maybe once a week, twice a week max. If we had to cut out the fish, we could, because we get the B12 supplementation from spirulina and the supplement. And the reason we don't have B12 in our food is because the mineral has been diminished in our soil. So, you know, there's something that the cow does when she eats the grass and when they eat whatever. It breaks things and makes it B12. Our human bodies can't make B12. So, you know, there are certain things our body makes.
Yeah, that's one of the things that they hold against vegans, is that they don't have enough of their, you know, amino acids, or they don't have enough of their vitamins and minerals and their protein.
And even the people that don't eat, because everything that, the reason you get your B12 is because the majority of stuff that you're eating is fortified with vitamins and minerals, from your cereal to your grains to what they feed your cows that has the B12 in it. So it's not that the cows, it's just they feed the cows, and then the cows, something within their system creates that enzyme.
But the problem is that they're feeding the cows suffering. As well.
Yeah, we watched this horrific little documentary yesterday, which we shared on our Facebook page, and we could probably link the video on this video. What's it called? Glass? If slaughterhouses...
If slaughterhouses had glass windows, everyone would be
vegetarian. And that was done by Paul McCartney.
Yeah.
The actual...
It was actually PETA.
PETA, yes.
Sponsored that.
So yeah, I'm not trying to push everybody to do anything that you don't want to do or to feel guilty, but you know, your health is important. I mean, that's the only thing that you really have. You could have all the money in the world. If you're unhealthy, you're not going to be happy.
No.
So health and love are the two most important things that everyone strives to achieve, but they're going about it the wrong way.
So let's pause.
Okay, and then when it's done, it's probably another 15 minutes or so. We're not going to ramble with the remainder. You hear enough of that on Tuesdays from us, yeah. But we wanted to do this for you guys, and we will try to do at least once a month or twice a month like this. And actually, maybe even add it as part of the show.
Yeah.
The segment of the show.
Yeah.
You know, this won't be added on the segment of the show. This is just because I know you guys have been waiting a long time for this, and a lot of emails saying, you know, why didn't you put up a
cooking video.
So here's your cooking video, and we'll be back shortly with the final result of our yummy.
Put what together?
And there is the yuca that has been boiling for a while, and your camera's gonna get all. What's up here?
Very hot.
Very, very hot. Now try this in. Okay, so what I'm gonna do first is go over here, and we're going to go ahead and blend all these goodness. I just saw a bug fly. What are we gonna put in here?
I don't know.
I know it's dinner time. It makes a lot of noise. It doesn't take a lot, just, I mean, this thing is like...
It's done.
And I like it chunky, yeah. So we don't, like, really overly blend. And it's like...
Ooh,
amazing stuff.
Wow.
There's a straggle over there.
Yeah.
I mean, these little blades are like,
glory.
That's a ninja for you. If you want it less thick, you blend it longer, add some more water. I only added a little bit. But this stuff is like pure goodness.
Nothing preserved.
No, and we use it all up.
Yeah.
Okay.
Lots
of dishes.
Huh?
Oh, that's done. Yeah. But I'm gonna cut up the yuca first.
Right.
And then, you know, that's all nice and done there. I mean, I can make it a little one more cook, but
no,
that's there. So what I do now is I grab a hold of this hot yuca. And I just kinda like cut it up.
I guess we're going back.
Well, I guess we could just at the end because I don't feel like it a little more, you know, softer than what it is. We got a barking dog.
You could do the same thing with sweet potatoes, right?
Yeah, with sweet potato. All right, so we're going to try to see if this thing is done more. Yuca usually takes a lot longer than like sweet potato.
Because it's a harder...
Harder, yeah.
Isn't it like a...
It's a root.
Don't they call it a... Oh gosh, what's the word? I know it's called a root, but it's called something else. A tuber.
A tuber, yeah.
Yeah.
Probably not going to have all of it because I made more than usual. Just, and if we can't eat all that, that's
we'll save it.
We'll save it for tomorrow. So what I do here is I cut this up. For me, one for you, that kind of thing.
So exciting.
Alright.
This is the riveting television part. Cutting a yuca.
Yeah.
Oh, that's one of the things about yuca is that you gotta watch out.
It's got these starchy.
It's got these little spiny, like fish scales on it or something.
Well, no, it's just a very starchy thing. And it's not. Won't be able to chew it up.
Yeah, it's like gristly.
Yeah.
And the same for the rest. We're going to eat it all.
You know we can down it.
So, well, there's no point.
There's three. Should I save one? I mean, that's
that was the plan. Because we got all that.
That's true. Okay. All right, so now, let me pull this out. Now we're going to take this bad boy here. That's not the kind of follow. This bad boy here. Where did my... there you go.
So now it's all cooked and ready. And notice how we use our oven. We don't.
This is the oven that we do use.
And let me guess, you're going to divide it
yes.
in half. One for me, one for you. There's a ball.
These are trying to do on two and two that will also be here on Christmas.
So notice the bowl is getting more
and more filling.
And more full.
Tomato.
What?
I said I was just buying the tomatoes.
No. Sort of looks like chicken burgers.
It looks like cheese.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. I
that now, as you all see here, now the deliciousness goes on top. I mean, there is nothing boring about this. It taste to die for. You got all natural flavors. Lots of wholesome calories.
I felt a little drop on my toe.
Oh, no?
Yeah.
I'm sorry about that. I like your toe.
Like it.
We want to keep this PG. All right, we're done here. So,
goodness.
There's a final product.
So then, you know, we just get our forks and we're going to dig in.
Yeah.
Eventually, after we get seated on our big comfy couch.
Yeah, and put some of my stuff away. But anyway, guys, your health is very important. Eating healthy doesn't have to be boring, and you don't have to starve yourself. We're far from starving. And, you know, at 52 and at 46, I'm weighing 131 pounds, and you're 161. So, all right, guys, love you. But remember to love yourselves, too. Take care.